Peace FM 104.3. Good to meet you.
We have created a critical mass of a commitment to sustaining this democracy. I think so. And it's across the political divide, let's be honest. But anytime I made a dumb statement, you know, it's because of my recognition that there's a lunatic fringe that could always create problems. And see, not today, or today, you're alert as a nation. The point there, Kwame, looking at just those pictures, I'm going to do something with those pictures. What's about the kitchen knife? It's me with the democracy, kitchen coup. Okay, Kwame, so I remind you, there was a one man, one machete coup. There were publications in our hat with the buy. Very interesting, you have to read those things. No one meaning, won't go back and won't go read the damn man. Ekai, the three essay mercenaries now. And I use the
so called mercenaries.
They were escorts, three SA escorts, if you want their precision. But the politics of it, we were told that they were mercenaries. Yadama.
Yeah.
Agalgan, my main yankun.
My classmate Agalga.
My Okasa Sisia. Described him as dangerous. He was then deputy minister for interior. Also, they were dangerous characters and a threat to national security. Mami, in your money, bini, plastic guns, replica guns, training knives.
Knife, Abima.
Training knives, web belts, golf shirts. PT shorts. Paint walls. Mosquito quills.
Mosquito quills. Bazo.
Black pants.
Oh, okay. Stop ridiculing this.
Whiteboard cleaner. A4 printing paper. Or 35 items here. We can read all. But these are
mercenaries.
These are the things they brought into town. And when it was put out, Agarga, the minister to Kukwanyedo, 31st March 2016. AtinkaOnline.com source. NPP imported SA3 to detonate bombs.
Oh, buddy.
Nobody, but.
Ayarga, I'll say, Agalga, rather. Three SA escorts, dangerous characters.
That's right.
2nd April 2016. Source classfmonline.com. Then James Ajinimbwati. I like him. He's such a gentleman.
Still a gentleman.
Even a village chief will be concerned about the three SA cops in Ghana, presidential staffer Ajinimbwati.
Village chief now has a knife into Monte.
I mean, why in the why be you shot? Too much. The village chief.
The village chief is back.
To be concerned. Offer now I be groomer with plastic guns and replica guns. And this was widely reported. Indeed, so, they were charged.
Mosquito corn was smoking out.
BBC, VOA, CNN all reported it. I'm sure the investors had gone into hiding.
This is a general discussion.
If it appears a personal shot, it's redrawn.
But so, Kwegu, who refer to Sanima to achieve what?
No, remember.
Exactly.
Good question. But that's see, illustrated one. if investor confidence is an issue, if such reports are made, and those who are making that case made such publications, first, the hypocrisy, the double standards, the selective amnesia. But truly, I don't agree that it affects investor thing. I don't.
Yes.
Was that your position in 2016?
Of course. The truth is that I challenged the characterization of those people as mercenaries. And it's here. I've got all my facts here. But Kwame, don't forget that we don't call court.
Okay.
This are the case.
Until we deport one eventually.
Eventually, we'll remove him, if you want to be precise.
Removed, yeah.
The Immigration Service withdrew their visas. So they were removed out of our territory.
No, but I said there were genuine reasons why their visas were withdrawn.
Oh, I don't want to go in there because it's not really the subject.
The subject,
but
okay.
But truly, contestable.
Kwegu?
Yeah.
Something to make you laugh.
Yeah.
Tell Kweku Bako the mosquito repellent was deliberately brought in for a certain member of the then government. I haven't mentioned
it. Oh, I see. Oh, your sense of humor. General Mosquito, are you there? It's Kwame. But you see, all this aside, or reflect in your collective sense of humor. I mean, nature and go for a raise, oh, court, we'll call court in the charge sheet, no, you're funny. Or you quit with the contents.
No, but that's the truth.
Oh, it's too early. And I'm so surprised that people don't know how these things work. Look, it's different from, remember another classic case. And that was really incompetence and ineptitude in terms of a classic case of it. Kennedy Japon's case. Me charges somebody in the court and even the wrongful, and which is admitted here by the Attorney General's office, making the one official document. Kwame.
Kwegu.
First charges are what the man treason, contrary to section 180 of the Criminal Offences Act 1960.
Genocide now.
We will infra the crowd. Treason felony, contrary to so and so and so. Attempted genocide. A, now what they started. And everybody told them. This was a gentleman who had called into a radio program, made all sorts of irresponsible and indeed potentially volatile statements, as in my candid opinion, and some of us sat here and took him on. Eventually, I mean, when they went round about different courts, Nyama, Baya Basa, ne Attorney General, Ma Attorney General's department officials, be require research, the research document, and so on. And based on the advice, they now changed all the charges and went to the appropriate
forum.
And the charges now were provocation of rout, contrary to section 200, section 196, 1A of Act 29, 1960. B, offensive conduct, contrary to section 207 of Act 29. Committee one. That is the problem. Eventually, so even this, the ruling Namikete, he was acquitted, discharged and acquitted because the prosecution made no case.
Lawyer,
defense raise, a case of no submission of no case.
Mm-hmm.
So the judge went into the merits and said, true. Prosecution, my case, boy, Obama defense, boy, Opi, no defense.
No, this is
no. It's a classic case, but Kwame,
yeah,
Ikaya, what can the president before came in and said that he's like killing
a fly with a sledgehammer?
And then we were told by President Mahama, Vice President Mahama, then there they will use a bulldozer.
That's right.
This was reported as somebody who had declared war and had asked Akans to go out and look for Akans and Ewes or Voltairians and beat up Nyadama.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The BBC, CNN, and all the rest published those stories. The investors were still in hiding.
You rest your case.
In terms of the judicial process, first of all, there was a 48-hour constitutional limitation you had to beat. Two, the purpose in court in the Dan was clearly to get that 48-hour limitation out of the way.
That's right.
You get them remanded. See, Kwame, in Mokora, the 15 months, you know, was a surveillance, you know, or intelligence gathering. It gets to a stage, those in charge decided that this is the time to effect arrest. Post-arrest is investigations and interrogation. Investigations and interrogation will lead to compilation of a docket. Church mercy. There's nothing like a docket. It's too early.
Mm-hmm.
We're interrogating. Watch. Interrogation, of course, may have started by now. Investigation is ongoing. There are other guys involved. But I am aware that there are audio and video recordings. Because that gang was infiltrated. Of course.
So in effect, the story is true.
Well, I will not say they are guilty. I'm not a judge. And it would be so unfair to say so.
Yeah.
But I think the story is factual. As to their guilt or otherwise, by within the remit of a court of law. And it would be unfair on my part to sit here and create the impression that BB Amekano would put together amount to a basis for a judge to say they are guilty. I can't do that. It would be so unfair.
So now drink water, let me continue.
When this case travels from where it is now, because that place is so preliminary, but men would they be more prematurely ejaculate?
But is he?
This FM 104.3. Good to meet you.